And overwhelming them bank accounts, but they didn't know where their debit card was. So this is something that we launched very recently. So we are the largest membership, paying membership club in India. We launched this on January 4th of this year, and we call it Smart Budget Club. The idea of Smart Budget Club is sort of like Costco, but tailored to the Indian setup. In the 45 odd days that we launched it, we now have 7,000 paid subscribers. These customers have 50% higher frequency on the platform and 30% higher spending. So the whole idea of brand Smart Budget Club is getting the customers to actually pay up front. Access to lower prices on the platform. So one thing that shows us is higher loyalty. And as an online platform, that's a huge advantage. We have to be able to show multiple prices to the customers. Show different levels of discounts based on what kind of membership they have bought. So right now, I think we are within the next month, we should cross the largest paid loyalty program in the country. So none of these memberships are paid to the platform. This is something that is low failure for our category. This is inherently high speed category, which is working. The other thing that is really, really good for us is working with a lot of local manufacturers. Even though they were just in the post GST, a lot of local manufacturers had a lot of trouble getting onto retailer shelves because limited shelf space, they were always fighting, most of them don't have the two networks. So the way we work with them is we give them a single point of contact, so all this stuff can come to one of our warehouses and then from there to the customer. They don't have to worry about it. So now local brands almost account for 13% of our overall volume. And as you can see, that some of the very, very interesting categories like oils and ghee, local brands we found have been able to like switch a lot of local customers from national brands that I think get significant market share. So, talking about what does it take to sort of run an operation like Grofers. So, we have average rating of 4.2 on the app store. Our average order rating is also 4.4 when customers rate the great experience on the platform. 70% of our customers on their first order itself give us a rating of 5 on delivery experience and sort of what they are doing. We actually invested a lot in delivery tech and our warehouse tech. So everything from the point where we did the purchase order and we connect to manufacturers. From that point on to the products actually getting all the way to the customer's hand. All the entire technology system actually built in house. So we own our own warehouse management system, inventory management system, picking, handheld picking, trade tracking. All of this is something that we actually have to build in house so that we are looking to where the products are. Similarly, the delivery tech side, we actually have a proprietary algorithm for route optimization based on what our department is. We right now have the highest efficiency both in terms of warehouse, picking, packing, and starting order for the delivery. We have a van right from delivery from the stores every day. Which is very, very quick for cattle. However, one of the greatest differences that has come from our platform has been recommendations. So since the grocery, unlike e-commerce, discovery is a relatively smaller part of the overall process. People buy pretty much the same things every month, time and time again. And they're not sort of looking to diversify their product. It's not like you bought a cell phone and you need to now buy a case to. People are mostly buying the same things at a particular period. So we introduced a few features. One was obviously reorder, which is what you see on the in the middle screen. But we also introduced some problems. Populated districts are coming back and telling you these are things you might be running out of based on what your previous frequency of users have called. And also helping customers discover new categories of products. So let's say somebody buys a new product on the platform, introducing them to a fabric softener at the same time if somebody is basically buying a particular kind of art on the platform, introducing them to a dance or other dairy and stuff like that. That is something which has helped us increase our average order size. But if you look at the amount of conversions on the right side, the automated is basically what customers are, when we show the customers what is the items they might be running out. So whenever we show a customer those items, 25% of them tend to check out. It's a very, very high conversion rate. So one in four customers actually sees that recommendation and actually makes it So a lot of the work that we can do on the consumer side, working with consumers, working with doing a lot of consumer research, is actually everything targeting how are we going to get smart recommendations, how are our products going to be more relevant to the customers, that is that we're trying to solve. So our, we have three different analysts in this plan on our platform right now. Recommendations, and we always try to keep tweaking them to make sure that we provide the most relevant stuff. This is actually what our overall ecosystem looks like. So when we work with brands, right from the time that we get products from the brand, all the way to the consumer ordering and actually getting the products, everything is tracked, everything is available in the system. A lot of this info is not just centric on what the customers are looking for, but also sort of what happens during the order process that we can leverage. So for instance, one of our biggest challenges right now is making sure that we reduce the process time between when the customer places the order and when the customer actually gets the product. So in order to do that, what we are now starting to do is actually doing a lot of pre-packaging, which is something we mentioned in the last session. We actually have three packages at the beginning of the month, a basket of products that we know are very, very heavily sold. So at the beginning of the month, when we do our wholesale, a lot of the key SKUs, Ashura Raka, Surf, Excel, a lot of these products are already moved to the front of the warehouse and put into place that can basically be picked up and you don't need to repick the orders timely. It basically allows us high efficiency and it allows us to get the products to the consumer cost to the university. That's all I have to offer. If anybody has any questions, please let us know. The majority of the platform is actually nothing to do with the service. It is basically the service doesn't resonate. It is not a need that they see in that thing. It is something like that. Because they might have different behavior, they just get out of it, they install the app because they have space on their phone, and then they just forget to be. So that's the biggest source of it. In the customer that actually stick around, the biggest reason is for customer to stick around is the malicious content. Whereas the biggest reason for trial is usually pricing, the biggest reason for sticking around is the So I don't know if that answers your question. Yes, so we have a portion. We, on an average day, we only do around, I think we do around 60,000 products through our cold chain. So the cold chain is two parts of us, one is ambient and the other one is central. So we meet two people who are actually close to the cold chain, and a lot of the fruits and butter and kitchen beans, we basically run through the regular cold chain. We have still not made very heavy investments for cold chain. So our capability, I think, is maybe deliver like 80,000 items per day in the top 70. But I think in the next year, from 2019, then we will actually at a scale where we'll be able to start new growth technologies. So I think we're just waiting to get to that scale before we start. We don't. But we do provide customers with a low price guarantee that if they find the price cheaper at the retailer, they can product within the app, they can pay in that difference and we will miss it. Quality comparisons? No, not really. So on the private label products, we try to provide a lot of quality data, but we don't sort of benchmark it to certain guidelines. This is our quality system. Yes. No, we don't. I think there was a point in time when we experimented with that, but we didn't really find that was an extreme category.